this year. We want to get together. We want to, you know, it's all about really just expanding the movement. You know, creating an umbrella where our alumni can come together. And, you know, of course, when we all come together at that point, great ideas and good things happen.
So for us, it's a very good opportunity to give back to the school, to network with, you know, the fellow alumni, and also to give back to the community. Really grateful that I have the opportunity to see my friends and my brothers.
It's just great to get together to think about giving back to a community that gave you a lot when your foundation years, when you were growing up. So I'm glad to be here. I'm from London, England, and I'm here for the 3 days, and hopefully we'll have lots of fun, get our heads together to find meaningful ways that we can be able to give back to our community, which is FGC Enugu.
I must confess that Free Anglo-American College Enugu has been a very wonderful institution. It's more of an alchemy industry which has made gold out of base metals that we wear when we went in there. And I'm very grateful to all the staff that taught us, and my fellow students that through my interaction with them also helped me to achieve what I am today. It's going to be a great weekend. I look forward to being there all through. And I believe that at the end of this session, that we're going to do great things for the school. So that the students that will pass through there will enjoy the same things that we did enjoy in the good old days.
Today is the food bank volunteer. We always do this. We started in Atlanta, went to the food bank there in Georgia, and then the next year was DC. We volunteered in the DC food bank. Now we're in Houston. The third year, I'm standing here with my good friend, my classmate.
Too short.
He needs no introduction. He's known everywhere. Worldwide as a fine artist. So I'll let Tusha tell us a little bit of what we're trying to do.
We're here to give. I really have no clue what the details are, but Houston will know we are in town today. So look out for the red shirts. Yeah, FGCE gives. This your love don't anger my heart. And before you know I'm, I go carry you go see my mama.
Well, we are here at the Houston Food Bank, and we are here 200 strong FGCE Enugu alumni, and we are here to give back to the community here in Houston, and we're doing it, and we're having a great time.
This is FGCE alumni, the Americas, with our brothers and sisters from all over the world, here at the Houston Food Bank, volunteering and giving back. Not just giving back, but we're having fun doing that.
Change FGCE, we're going to give back to the school, we're going to return FGCE to the type of school where we want our children to go to. So that's what we're doing here, but we're also giving back to our local chapters. So we volunteered at our food bank, but we're volunteering at food banks all across Americas, all across Canada. So we're giving back, and for me, I have been inspired by others as well. So I thank everybody for coming. I thank everybody for giving. Let's do this. Let's take this to the next level.
You know, when we are planning a reunion, we organize locally. We start to volunteer within the community, right? We want to make sure that we give back and our impact is felt. Because in doing that, in giving charity together, our alumni, we strengthen the bonds between each other. And that synergy that the team creates in any local area where they're volunteering together, they're having events together, that synergy actually translates into energy that makes a reunion pretty successful.
Shine the light, oh, when me you de, when man no sleep, they walk all night. Don't just sign, small boy turn to biggie man. Small boy buy your mama house. Small boy drive the kicker. Blessing follow the small boy, oh, yeah. When me you, yes, when me you, down in the gutter back then, when me you, yeah. When me you, when no BMW, now nah, me stack a table, bank you W, eh. I be at them coma. Now my life you not get coma. I be at them coma. Charlie, me I no believe my power, yeah.
So I'd like to call up a very distinguished alumni. He's from the class of 1977. We call them the pioneer class because that is the first class that started and finished. Actually graduated. And so I'd like to call up Chidi Mama. He's the secretary and general counsel for the NNPC. And he's here and he's going to address us for just a few minutes.
I don't know all the people who organize this, but whoever you are, I need to say you have done a fantastic job. Fantastic job. And whoever is in the committee, please, I need for you to put your hands up or stand up to be acknowledged. And so that those of us who have just shown up here can at least appreciate the fact that you guys have done a fantastic job to put this together. So all the members of the organizing committee, can you please at least stand up to be acknowledged? Those of you who are in this hall. Please give them a big hand of applause. Thank you very, very much. Thank you very much, guys. And I look forward to next year's own. I can't express in words how happy I am to be here. I stand before you a very humble student of a great institution. The amount of talent in this room, the people I've spoken to, the kinds of things you're doing here, I need to say that I am extremely proud and very humbled by what you guys have done for FGC Enugu. And a lot of the good things that are coming up are based on what you guys have done, and it's important that that work continues. So I need to say congratulations to all of us, to all of you, and long may FGC Enugu last.
Gala
share the booze. Everybody wanna talk and do,
I talk, I do,
cause I know they for fuck and do,
they do, they do,
dance for reggae, dance for blues,
they blues, they blues,
I turn by turn, like they do,
they do, they do,
oh yeah, my madam, hey.
Dance for me, my madam, I like how you padam, I spray you many dollars,
oh yeah, no, my madam,
dance for me, my madam,
share the booze,
the booze, the booze.
Everybody wanna
groove, the booze, the booze.
As far as the money they pay,
they pay, they pay.
He be old pop champagne, baby say I'm more than good.
To make sure that what we're doing is something that all alumni get behind and feel like this is something that they have a voice in. The idea is to be able to bring leadership from the UK, leadership from Nigeria, leadership from the US to come together and let that group figure out where is this foundation going to go.
Good morning. My name is Obioma Liel Imoke. I am class of 78, and
my name is Chidi Moma, Honesty House, class of 77.
I'm Good Luck FMYA, and I'm of the HSC class of 1974.
Awesome. Seriously, I don't even know how to congratulate those who and they've been working quietly and steadfastly. You guys have been. You understand what I mean? And if I didn't see that, honestly speaking, I'll stay in my quiet corner. Because, you know, like when we look at those WhatsApp amongst ourselves, we say, now, wow, these children are something else. So, you know, so we're proud to be associated with you. And we hope that our contributions will make a difference to what you're doing. Thank you.
Everywhere we have a chapter, we give back to the community. We feel that, you know, while most of our charitable work is focused at the school, we want to also do things in the community, right? And in doing that, we play our role, right, in helping write, whether it's a chapter, whether it's a sentence, whether it's a word, but write something positive in the global narrative about Nigerians. We have the intellectual firepower, the resources, the network. We're all united, and we want to give back to FGCE. We want to do it in a way that tells a good story that we can all be proud of as FGCE alumni and as Nigerians. So that is our mission. That mission, we do not compromise it. That mission is not up for debate. If we raise money for a project, everything that we do, every dime that changes hands, all through the process, is something that we know that, you know, is that something that we can come back to our donors and say we're accountable. You're never going to hear us say that, you know, we gave money to somebody to do something.
We've handled over $300,000 since 2014, and luckily I think we are balancing to about $1, reconciling to about $1, so very transparent.
I came to Federal Government College in Enugu in 1994, and by 2014 I became the principal of the college. I have spent 20 years in the school training all my children. I trained 10 children. I had six biological, four foster children who lost their parents. I trained all of them in Federal Government College in Enugu. So I believe I owe that college a lot. So when I was made principal, I felt it was time to give to the college. I began to make plans that were bigger than I can imagine, bigger than myself. And as I made those plans, I saw God in it, because soon after I thought of things I could do to turn the college around, I had a visit from Dr. Abim. He came to the office, and when he came, I saw interest, I saw commitment, I saw love, I saw ideas. We talked for a long time. He was so concerned with making the school better, academically and otherwise. And somehow, we were thinking alike. We shared ideas, and it was like, madam, what you want to do is exactly what we want to do. There was this agreement of the mind and an understanding that this college can do better in our times. And I thank God that all the discussions I held with him, the projects, when I talked to him about giving the gate a facelift, it was like he will not buy it, because it's something aesthetic and we are talking about things that really matter. But I was happy when he came back, and it was that every project we had mentioned was taken up by the old students in the Americas. I was excited when I saw a lot of progress in the plans. The raising of funds, the structured manner with which you people organized the tenders, it made it possible for us to have the best hands to execute the projects. I was excited to see that within 3 months, you had executed all the 5-6 projects in the college. Like I said, if I begin to say things, I will take your time. I don't want to do that. I just came here to salute this great gesture of giving back to your college. I have come here to salute a classical example of people who are committed to doing something and going ahead to do it. I am here, like I said, to thank you, to appreciate you for giving back to your college in grand style. In grand style, I'm glad I came in your midst this evening. Thank you, and God bless you.
And I want to use this opportunity again to thank all the philanthropists, alums that gave, and those that supported, you know, moral support, financial support, and even those that just kept cheering us up. I mean, that was amazing. And we couldn't have achieved this without your help. So we've...
improvements to the water systems in the school, and there's still a lots of need for improvements to water systems. The next item I wrote, toilets. Guys, this school does not have any functioning toilets in the dormitories. That is the truth.
We know that the federal government should be doing funding. We are working to, like I said, deepen our partnership with the school. But A, we cannot deny the urgency is now, you know? And secondly, also, the fact that we are doing things gives us that opportunity to say, let's get a seat at the table. We're here to help, but we also want to understand. So it's a parallel approach for us, right? We're going to keep working because we see that the need is right now. Parallel to that, we're going to also make sure that we understand that we're not heating a house without windows in the winter.
It's appalling to see the state our school is in. Even though we've done a lot more needs to be done. And I will start this fundraising by personally, in addition to everything that I've donated so far, starting with a $1,000 donation.
I'd like to pledge $1,500 to this cause.
We gave a donation of $1,000.
An additional $2,000 would have been before.
$2,000, and I'll renew that pledge for 5 years.
5 years. From our Oga Liga. Fantastic.
I'm supporting you guys with $5,000.
Pledge $1,000 for the next 3 years. Pledge $1,500 a year for 4 years, so I continue with that.
For $1,500 a year for 3 years, I maintain that pledge.
On behalf of my family, I give you guys $1 million.
$1 million. $1 million. Let him clarify before I run with the dollar.
I work in Nigeria. We make naira, so I give $1 million naira.
The hands are up. I don't know which way to go.
$300,000 naira.
$2,000.
With the sum of $500,000. $500,000.
Having seen what I just seen today, I'll do $10,000 over 3 years.
Wow. Wow. You need to stand up and clap. Stand up and clap. $10,000 for 3 years. $30,000. We are here to fundraise. We are here to change the school. We are here to change Nigeria, starting with our alma mater. And please, I ask every single one of us, If you know your area of expertise, raise your hand. Raise your hand and come to our aid and join us in building a superpower alumni. It's not just money. Your service is in what you do.
Well, tonight is going to be a black tie event. We'll be doing some fundraising and having fun, you know, networking and, you know, putting her together on how to make our alma mater the best.
You see, say we dey run the city. I don't think that any one of you can step to titty. I just wanna sing the song. Break it down, oh yeah, shake it to the ground.
Yeah, Baba God don't bless us. Now why we dey talk this matter? Some people want to pull me down, I still dey walk out.
No be say them say, no they do like say you know no. No be say them say, my brother.
Oh yeah, Joe for me. If I start to talk,
the team where I don't take my eyes, see we no going. My brother, we no going. If I start to count,
this is an opportunity to say thank you for the charitable and social work that you do, educating, providing the stair steps of leadership for those who will follow behind, and to give the name of this great college and institution a name of civic responsibility. And the federal government college is deeply committed to collectively giving back to the cause of education in Nigeria, because they serve to give a hand up and not a hand out. And so on behalf of the United States Congress, it is my privilege to present this resolution to you and all of those who are part of this great organization and this great reunion. You are deserving of the respect, admiration, and commendation of the United States Congress of the United States of America. Sheila Jackson Lee, Member of Congress, August 13, 2016. Congratulations to you. God bless all of you. God bless your great nation, and God bless the United States of America.
In this hall tonight are so many accomplished alumni. Any secondary school would be rightly proud of the people that are gathered in this room tonight. By this measure, then, FGCE Enugu has been hugely successful. And it is in the spirit of giving back, of nurturing our shared heritage, that we, the HRF of North America, are proud and delighted to join the Association of FGCE Alumni in the Americas as diamond sponsors of this reunion and fundraiser to benefit FGCE Enugu.
There's more money raised this time around. We're not just here to party. We raised a ton of money today, and we're going to raise more. We raised before the party, we raised before the reunion, we raised over this weekend. We're going to raise more as time comes on.
We raised $76,000 before we got to Houston. I know last count this afternoon, we were probably close to $80,000 additionally raised as of this afternoon. I don't know. I will wait to hear from our treasurer and financial secretary. But I know that all through the evening, people kept putting checks in my hand, and I kept giving it to our treasurer, our financial secretary.
We're raising money because we've proven, Nnemeka, the president and the board, IK, that when we get the money, we maximize the value of the donation. So people are giving because they can see that it's going to good works for a good school.
The fact that we're able to deliver all the projects promised in Washington, D.C. 2015, it's just amazing. You know, it's just amazing. Because like he rightly articulated, that brought a lot of energy, that brought a lot of trust and confidence. And I know that most alumni left home today knowing that their money is safe with us. Because in executing those projects, we really implemented all, you know, the best practices of project management, just to make sure we stayed very transparent, we carried the shareholders along, and we got the best of contractors. And the amazing thing was that the contractors ended up being alums as well. So they did it like they were doing their job. So, I mean, it can't be better than that.
Very moving, you know, to see how bad it was before we came in, and then to see the difference and to see the smiles on their face, you know.
These children in Africa, in Nigeria, at Federal Government College Enugu are our leaders of tomorrow. The training we give them today is what they will use to take care of us tomorrow. It's the training they will use to lead our nations tomorrow. We need reasonable, competent leaders in the future. We must invest in our children so that they can give back, so that they can give exactly what we give them back to the community.
Well, as we all know, in the Nigerian community that most of us come from, just the act of trying to give back to the community, trying to help, is not really a well-established practice. And it's awesome to see that culture beginning to change. This is small. This is just a school, just Federal Government College. But you can imagine what this implies if this is going to become a much wider practice in the Nigerian community, that we are able to give back to where we come from and lay a good foundation for those that are coming up behind us, our children and our children's children. So it's really an honor, a great pleasure to be able to be part of this growing culture.
From the first time that I set my eyes on you, baby, I was stuck on you. Mama, me a cut for you, make my body call for you, all for you. Went back inside my dream to search for you, looking like a dream come true, cause you make my dream come true. Baby, I will stand by you, with you, cause you are my woman, womanly. Cause you are so woman, woman sweet. Come here, Mr. Roman, romantic. Come and make you feel good, oh, romantic. Cause you are my woman, womanly. Cause you are so woman, woman sweet. Come here, Mr. Roman, romantic. Come and make you feel good, oh, grooming dreams. Let's show you, oh, yeah, show them, show, let's show them, show them. Make we let London know. Yeah, my baby so romantic. Oh yeah, baby, make we show them, let's show them, you show them. Make we let London know. Jealous you, they just wanna be boom, be boom. Cause when you put me plus you, it's gonna be unstoppable. Oh, baby, come on over, got a kiss for you. Waiting on you, waiting on you. You know I know what is good for you. I can make your dreams come true. Boy, I be a woman, womanly. I can be a woman, woman sweet. Call you Mr. Roman, romantic. Say you make me feel good. Mr. Romantic, I could be a woman, womanly. I could be a woman, woman sweet. Call you Mr. Roman, romantic. See, you make me feel good, Mr. Romantic.
Time to show you, oh, yeah. Show them, show them, show them, show them, show them. They could let London know. Yeah, my baby so romantic. Oh yeah, baby, make me show them, show them, let's show them.
Nobody really knows.
people, we've worked so hard. Alumni have been so generous, just selflessly donating time, money towards this wonderful project.
It's a lot of work to do, a lot of things that we're proud of, and we're just happy that this was a success.
Houston is honestly the best reunion that we have ever had.
The infectious spirit of every volunteer that has made this event possible is something that cannot be described.
Over 400 people, actually. Yes. The biggest meeting they've had so far. Incredible, incredible.
You know, there's a lot of enthusiasm. A lot of people are really amped up about this. And we think we're going to be able to transform that school back to its glory days again.
The energy that we have had in the last 3 days.
I can't describe it, honestly.
The passion that these young kids exhibit for, you know, their alma mater, it's incredible. It's incredible, it's infectious.
More and more of our alumni all over the world are becoming aware of this movement and are really interested in finding ways to participate and finding ways to support the programs that we've initiated.
I've never been so committed to a cause that as I am right now. I'm excited.
I think things are only going to get better from here, you know. I think, you know, year after year, it looks like this is getting bigger and bigger. We're having people from London, people from Europe, people from Nigeria coming to join this. And I think, you know, the more I put a joint effort, the better things are going to be for the school. So I'm very excited about this.
It's wonderful. You know, it's like last year was my first one and I enjoyed it and I knew that I would never miss any other one. Even if it's going to be in the moon, I'll go.
Anyone that missed this, better not miss it next year. Come down to London, have fun, give back to your school. Every little helps, and meet your old friends.
I would implore any old student of Federal Government College, Enugu, any alumni who hasn't had this experience, that this is something to be experienced.
It's truly fun. This is the third one that I've been to, you know, and I'm going to encourage everybody, if you have the opportunity, don't even think twice, you know, make it happen.
The impact, it's honestly immeasurable.
The unity, the singularity of purpose, working towards the same goal, it's really something to behold.
This is something you shouldn't miss.
To start with, this is going to make many other alumni be active and participate. And then when the students see what the old students have done for them, they in turn will grow up and leave school and will want to be part of this movement.
We're definitely growing up in the depth and breadth of our alum, of the reach of alumni who were brought to the table, right? In today's meeting, there's a guy who left Federal Government College in Enugu in 1974. I was 2 years old.
A network like this, it's capable. I mean, if you look around, you would see that there are leaders in different professions, different areas.
I went to the school and I felt this was special. I tell people, everybody's like, we went to a good school. I'm like, no, you don't understand. It's like every single person that went to my school was super smart, special.
You have doctors, you have engineers, you have politicians.
So I think that the reasonable thing to do and the fair thing to do is, since we've been so blessed by God, is to give back.
I love my school. I always say, you know, I wouldn't be where I am today if not for having attended FGCE. And the least I can do, just like I would help out my parents, is to, help out my school and contribute as little or as much as I can.
I mean, whatever we put our mind to, as long as we're working in synergy, we should be able to achieve.
For the first time, we have people, alumni who have come from all over the world, and alumni from the pioneer set of 1973-74 coming together to actually sit in one room.
I can see that they are focused, you know, they know what they're doing, they have a plan, they have a vision, they have a mission, and that is what they have set their eyes on. So I see it being like a tsunami. Every single person who is an alumni of this school is asking themselves, what can we do to be a part of this, to be able to bring some change, some kind of relief to the school?
So being here 3 years and seeing the growth, the achievements, what we've done for the school, just, you know, amazing. You know, solar lighting for all the kids, built a lot of things. It's excellence. That's what we have come to represent. It's a federal government college of excellence, not just Enugu.
My prayers is that what we have achieved today should just be the start for even greater things to come. There's a lot more we can achieve as long as we work as one.
The level of leadership that my president has shown, it's very impressive. His team of people working with him, his followers, we're building a strong, formidable force for the future generation. I see my children, my children's children, whether they were in FGCE or not, keying into this project. This project has come to stay.
You know, I've gone to some very good institutions around the world, and I know how this works. It's a symbiotic relationship. You raise your school, it raises you. And very soon, people are going to be saying, oh, you went to FGCE, Enugu, I want to hire you. I want to give you a job. I want to do business with you, because I heard it's a great school. So that symbiotic relationship is what I'm living on. I'm trying to be a part of. And that's what we call the movement. You know, we're trying to get that movement rolling.
It's a movement. It just keeps getting bigger and better.
It's a movement that is here to stay. That's what I can see.
The momentum is just moving.
I just think it's going to be like a tsunami very soon.
When all of us come with our different skill sets, you know, there's no limit to what we can do.
When I go back to Nigeria, I'm going to pass on the message.
Everyone that hears this better act, you know. So, honestly, we believe that in another year or two, every alumni of FGCE Enugu would have heard about us.
I thank everybody for coming. I thank everybody for giving. Let's do this. Let's take this to the next level.
I just want to say to everybody listening and watching that you should join. If you're not yet part of this association, please join. If you need to get more information, go to the website. It's www.fgcealumni.org. There you will find all of the information about this association. All your questions will be answered. That's what I did, and that is what motivated me to participate in Houston 2016, which by all measure has been an outstanding success.